have a good time. Put a smile on your face, yeah. KB Cam and Elation Radio. Even brighten your day and help you through the night. Bring you good music. KB Cam and Elation Radio. And here's your host.
Do you have an upcoming event? Well, I encourage you to book Beyond Defense Family for an amazing experience. Beyond Defense is a talented group of men and women who have toured the world to display their talents of song and ministry. Did I forget to mention multi-award winners? They're your one-stop shop for making your event the best in the city. Book Beyond Defense today at beyonddefense.org. Click menu, then contact. Beyond Defense, your audience will thank you.
Welcome, welcome, welcome to Beyond the Radio.
Welcome to Beyond the Radio. And you better be smiling.
Beyond the fences in the building.
Out of my religion, out of my religion. More of a culture that when you were here. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Yes. Welcome right here on Beyond the Radio. This your main man, your host, David Benton, the coach, and I am in the building. Thank you. Yes, shout out to the Elation family. We love you. You know, when we come up here, we are already prayed up. We trust the prayers of everyone on the network. So guess what? We just dive straight in. We got a wonderful topic for you guys tonight. That's right. And with that being said, can I get a drum roll? The coach, the songstress, the voice of an angel, Coach Shay Samuels, are you in the building?
Coach Shay Samuels is in the building, and I'm smiling. What's up, Elations family? Coach David Benton and the Beyond the Fence family. As always, we're just happy to be here with you guys another Sunday. I think life is so short. I think, you know, we need to just say we appreciate you. Every Sunday we get on, we appreciate you for taking the time out to listen. You could be doing anything in this world, but you're taking the time out to listen to Coach David and myself on another episode or broadcast of Beyond the Radio. So shout out to y'all. Hi, Coach David.
Howdy. That's my Tennessee talk. Howdy.
I know that's right. Speaking of Tennessee, did you guys have a game this weekend?
Yes, we played Kentucky. University of Tennessee, them Volunteers, they played Kentucky. Kentucky, the SEC. I don't hate them, but I'm not a big, huge Vol fan, but I rep them for as the fact because I'm from Knoxville, Tennessee. I like to see them win because, you know, they haven't won in a long time. But I'm not going to lie, I don't always go for them because it's like, you know, man, get some people out the city, man. We got a lot of good, great ball players right here in the city and of Knoxville, Tennessee, and you know when they don't recruit nobody from Knoxville, Tennessee, man, you know, kind of get a little offended. Now these guys are great at what they do. Now get these guys, man, they're right in your backyard. So you know, a lot of us don't really like University of Tennessee for things like that. But you know, shout out to UT, they are doing good this year, and you know, I do want to see them do good. So it's fine.
That's good.
But they play good. So we had a good event.
Yeah, I was going to beat you to the punch. Let's talk about your Thursday event first and foremost, because you had a busy weekend. So we had a great event Saturday, but you, the founder, had a busy weekend. So tell us about it.
All right. Shout out to my Fly High brothers, my song Fly High, Mr. Kobayashi, Jerry's Bush, Want Safe for President, them brothers from the Good Guy Collective, and they feature with me. Shout out to Giddy for doing the hook to Fly High from Nigeria. And, you know, the concourse, Kobayashi had an event. He was headlining really for his birthday. It was like a birthday present to himself. And he had a lot of support. And he asked me to do Fly High. And then, you know, he said, man, do that song Hip Hop that you have. It's not even out. He was like, man, could you, I love that song, man. I want you on YSA for President to do that. So we did it. And it was just a beautiful turnout. And, you know, the concourse, it's a club. But I got a chance to really express myself and just be me, man. And just, you know, all my music could never have, like, bad language or nothing. But, you know, Paul said, I become one of those that gain a soul. So the ones who using the profanity and talking about this and talking about that, I could at least speak a language where you can understand exactly where I'm coming from, and I'm speaking with empathy. And just to get those type of ears and they listen, they can tell that I can relate to their lifestyle or what they're doing or what they used to do or whatever. They can tell I've been there, done that. So when they listen, it's just a blessing. So, you know, I was in the club. You know, I performed in the club.
It's a good place to be. It's a good place to be. It's a good place to be. I love it. It's the biggest thing that I see from it all, too, Coach David, is when you can get invited to the club, honestly, that means that people see, like you said, they see such a blessing in you that you can be a blessing even in the club. So shout out to you, because not a lot of artists can be that versatile. So shout out to you for being one of those artists that can go from the pulpit to the club. So shout out to you, Coach David.
I appreciate that. That was dope. I like the way you worded that. That was so awesome. Made me want to start breakdancing. Because we need that.
Stick to the beatboxing.
Now, it's a good thing for you to say that, Coach Shay, because, you know, like, I do so many events in the church, and, you know, man, I love people so much, and, you know, you just want to give them something to just think about and something to smile about. And, you know, sometimes I look at the faces, and it's like they focused on the rap music, and they frown. And I just wish they would smile. I just wish I could make them smile. Like, man, I just want to give you something to be happy about, something to be blessed about. And so that's the thing. So
the truth of the matter is I can imagine them probably looking at their pastors the same way as the pastors preaching. I think there's a lot of people who have to, you know, people are still dealing with the things that they are dealing with in life, you know. I said this a long time ago about my family, so if they're listening, I would say shout out to you guys, but this is old feelings. So I remember probably like last year, you know, years prior, my family, my biological family, we always went through things. And so, you know, if somebody didn't pick up the phone, you would think that they had an issue with you, or people are just busy. And one day I just remember driving down the road and saying to myself, one of my cousins, who we all are cool now, you guys have seen us celebrating one another every year for the last 2 years. But I remember just wondering, what are they going through outside of the situation that we could have been going through? Like, maybe they're not answering the phone because they're going through their own battles, or maybe they're not answering, or maybe they're not coming because they're dealing with their own situations. This one particular cousin, her mother, my aunt, by marriage, but my aunt nonetheless, she passed away. Maybe she's dealing with something like that. So, Coach David, as you were talking, I was really just thinking, to be honest with you, a lot of people are dealing with stuff. And you know how when you go to church and the pastor's preaching to you and you think that person is talking about you, oh, that guy got to be all up in my business, all up in my class. Some people leave church just because they feel like the sermon was about them. You know what I mean? So it's amazing how music, especially your music, can prick the heart of people that way.
Right. I appreciate that. It just, you know, because me as an entertainer, I'm still a person who really loves hard. So when I'm doing music, you know, it is my act of service. You know, I do want to get the strong message across and to really help people to go beyond their fence. And it's like, that's the subject that what this is really based on, as far as us as human beings, it's okay to be different. And I think that's what we need to understand. It's okay. And a lot of us got a problem with understanding that it is okay to be different. And this scripture, Shay, I've heard you even say it many times, to where one man plant, one man water, but God gives the increase.
Yes.
And that's just, everybody have a responsibility for the same goal. And I think it's only fair to say, like, okay, well, one man plant, one man water, God get an increase. Why? Because it's designed that way. I might have a seed, and you may have a seed, and somebody else have seeds. Some people going to have rose petal seeds. Some people going to have grass. Some people going to have pine trees. Some people going to have grapevines. Some people going to have dandelions. But you know what? Each seed has a purpose after it grows. But that doesn't take the value away just because I have dandelions and you have roses. Okay, people don't come to the store to buy a dozen dandelions. But you know what? A dandelion serves its own purpose. It may be a purpose that you may not comprehend or understand. And you know what? That's fine. But don't look down on the dandelion, Mr. Rose or Mrs. Rose, just because people come buy a dozen of you for Valentine's Day and birthdays and, you know, just beautiful celebrations. That don't mean that the rose is more valuable than the dandelion. It serves its own purpose. So I think that's just what we have to understand as people.
I think, as you were talking, I was just thinking about, you know, football teams or basketball teams or just teams in general. Each person who is bought onto that team, they're bought on for a specific reason, and they all have a specific goal in mind, and ultimately it's to win. And whenever you, a coach is looking out, which, you know, because you're an athlete, you've played in many sports, so you know when a coach is looking, they're looking for a great team of people. Who are talented in different areas. And they're also looking for people, like you say, with great integrity, good character. And sometimes you don't find that. You know, I know for me, when I was playing basketball, you know, I used to get frustrated a lot. When I was playing basketball, corner me, I'm coming after you. But when the coach is looking, they're looking for specific things outside of just the talent. But like you said, you know, the Bible says that one man plants a seed, another man waters, but God gives the increase. And so as we're looking at these different types of talents, we can look at them as seed because each person is sowing something into the team. The coach is sowing, the team is sowing. Ultimately, of course, God is going to give the increase. But at the end of the day, the one thing that I want to emphasize with all of that is it takes work. You know, like you said, I've mentioned the scripture before. I used it when it came down to my Monday motivational moments, and I just said a seed is planted so that it can grow. On the other half, I'm going to talk about when it doesn't grow, but a seed is planted so that it can grow, but it takes work, right? So first and foremost, you got to go to the store to get the seed. Then you got to look to see what type of seed you want to sow, right? You got to go to figure out, like, when the seed is supposed to be planted, because it's not going to grow if it's not even planted in the right season, right? But then you got to dig up the dirt, and you got to put the seed down, and you got to cover the seed up, and you have to nourish the seed, which is what we're talking about tonight. But you may not be what fully nourishes it. At times, the sun is going to do that when you're not there, right? So when you were talking, Coach David, I was just thinking about, like you said, the many seeds that are there, the many seeds and opportunities that we have to plant into people. And if we're talking specifically about just the music tonight, really, it could be anything. I mean, you can sow seed at work.
Yeah, definitely anything. It's definitely anything.
Yes, you could.
It's so much more than music.
Back to you, Coach David. Shay.
All right, so, you know, it's so much more than music, you know. So it's like, me personally, you know, I understand, like, we all are different. And a lot of us have a problem because we're different. No people is just going to think alike 100% of the time. And I think that we have to be mature enough to respect that and understand that. Like, let's stop getting upset all the time just because that person doesn't agree with you or eat what you eat or look at what you look at or to believe like you believe. I think we waste so much time and energy. God is not getting the glory. God does not get in the glory just because that person is a Hindu. Okay, just stay away from them. You don't got to, like, eat with them or do whatever with them. But you can be polite still and still be cordial because that's who you are, your integrity. Okay, they don't believe like you. It was like that when you came into this earth. So you're telling me you're not used to that yet? You're not used to difference yet? You still have to be educated because people are different and you still have a problem? It's like that with racism. Because we're different. You know what I'm saying? So it's so much bigger than music. And I think us as a people, we have to really, like, be more comfortable with ourselves. You know, this world don't revolve around me only, but it do revolve around me because I got to live it. But I have to understand that other people are living in the same world and they got to deal with problems too. And they got to deal with my personality because I don't agree with everything other people say. But we all got to understand that that's just life and it's okay. So when I am getting back to the music and I'm in certain situations, I don't want nobody looking down on me because of what they believe or think. Because you can believe something that doesn't mean this is fact. It's just a belief. And that's just the reality of it. So if I know my heart is in the right place and I know my motive, then even myself would love to have encouragement. Even me myself would love for people to still receive it and say, okay, I don't have to like it, but I definitely respect it. And we appreciate you. I don't eat beets. I hate beets. I think beets is one nasty vegetable, but you know what? My mom loved beets. My dad loved beets. I think they're disgusting. But you know what? That doesn't make beets less healthy. It doesn't take away from the fact that there are people who love beets and understand that they are great for your body. I don't have to like them for them to still, you know. But right now, I respect them. I know they're healthy. I know they are good for you. I tell you, I should eat them. I just don't like the taste. I just really can't stand the taste. So, but I don't, like, talk bad about people who eat the beets. I understand that it's nourishment for their body and they're getting what they need. So it's a blessing for them to eat them beets. I will feed them the beets because I understand the power of and the value of beets. But me personally eat them, I can't stand the taste. And I, if that makes sense, Coach Shay, I mean, do you want to expound on, I know you was talking as well, you know, on the line of the seeds. So that's just how I see it with the music and without the music, that's all.
Yeah, I think in general, I just want to encourage everyone to be able to identify with the differences of others as we are beginning to sow. I think specifically in this world, as you said, Coach David, we all have been created purposefully to be a blessing. And I'm saying inside of church and outside. I believe that if you understand how powerful your words are and if you treated your words as seed, even when it comes down to your children, you know, I teach my granddaughter, shout out to my niece who came to visit in July. She's only like 12 years old. And while I was away, she was here spending time with my two daughters and grandchildren. And when I came back, she was like, Aunt Shay, I want to show you something. And she showed me how she was teaching my granddaughters to say, I am beautiful. That's seed. And I remember when my daughters were younger, I used to speak those type of things into them. You're intelligent, you're smart. But to know that my 12-year-old niece is learning to sow proper seed into her younger cousins who are only a year old and 3 years old. So all I have to say is to start us, I am, and my granddaughter is going to say beautiful. She's going to say smart. She's going to say intelligent. But that's because there's seed being planted in her by others. But we have to be mindful of the seed. And I'm talking about the good type of seed, but there's also, well, like what Coach David is saying, bad seed. it may not necessarily be in words, you know. And so I'm encouraging people tonight to think about what you're speaking over one another, what you talk about, how you talk it. It is so powerful. Coach David, just a few weeks ago, you were reminding me even about the power of just manifestation and just kind of what we're speaking and how we manifest things. And I taught on this a while ago, but the laws of attraction is real. You know what I mean? That is seed. What are you speaking into yourself, even if it's not somebody else? What are you speaking into yourself? If you're saying I'm always sick, then that's seed that you're sowing into yourself. I'm always sick. If you say I'm always going to be broke, that's seed that you're sowing into yourself. If you say I'm never going to be loved, that's seed you're sowing into yourself. And I'm going to share, after the music break, I'm going to share something real. What I love to do is be transparent regarding things that I go through, because I want people to know that regardless of how you see us as a family, Beyond the Fence family, and you may hear us on radio, and I know people might think, do they ever go through anything? We do. Recently with my two daughters, I experienced something that was like getting bad every single day. And I remember what I was saying. I'm going to share it, so you're going to have to stay tuned. But I'm going to share this story when we come back. But it was all because of the seed I was sowing. So it is important, Coach David, as you said, to be mindful of what you're sowing into yourself and what you're sowing around others. And I'll hand it back to you before I say that even your thought is seed. So I'm going to hand it back over to you, Coach David. You stay tuned, because I'm going to share something very powerful that really, really helped me to change the dynamic and the trajectory of how I operate, even in my own home. Back to you, Coach David.
I appreciate that. And I really do think it's very important. Like, I want people to understand that even though we in here, we on the radio, we're encouraging people, and we talk about how much we love people. Understand, I always talk about I did 13 years in federal prison. You know, so I can't say that I cross every T and dot every I. Even right now in my life, I got a lot of things that I got to go through. You know what I'm saying? We all got our imperfections, and they're only imperfections because we can affect someone else by our actions. Because if there's nobody around, it won't be no imperfection. You know what I'm saying? But as long as you got to deal with people, you just got to accept that you're different from the way they think. So let's try to control our emotions, try to control our tempers. You know, the Bible say, be ye angry, but sin not. So we have, sometimes it's necessary to get angry. But how do we handle the anger? You know, even myself, I've been out of control many times because of my anger. But that's when I got to say things like I'm saying now. Okay, it's time to reel it in and get under control. So you have control of your imperfection. Because now, if when I lose control, I'm really destroying other people with my words, and my words can turn into actions depending on the situation. So even me, myself, I got to encourage myself. I got to tell myself, man, calm down. Why? Because the power of manifestation. You can put curses on people without using profanity, people. Jesus cursed the fig tree. He didn't say, you boop, 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 fig tree, boop, 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 fig tree, boop, 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 fig tree. Jesus didn't do that. Just curse the fig tree without using profanity. So understand, me, myself, had to understand, I can curse people without using profanity. So every word is not a cursed word. It's a profanity. So we say cursed words. So we can lay them bad seeds. So power of manifestation, we speak more blessings over our own life and other people's life. I got to remind myself or be reminded by somebody every day about the power of manifestation. So we got to speak life. And I mean, and that's why birds of a feather should flock together, Coach. Eh? That's why it's important, because iron sharpens iron. And so with that being said, we had our break. So, where the music at?
Yeah, you say you're not a people person. Well, y'all got issues, but you gotta keep on working. Keep going, sweetie, don't defeat your purpose. Your heart lost, and you don't feel the need to search it. It's real out here, and you don't think it's some real men out here. Going in the towel, it's a weird idea. Although, it ain't been your year. You worth more than a Prada bag. You want a boyfriend or find a match? I'm gonna show you where to find a man. The right type, clean your life like a laundry man. Them little boys, you have time for that. Cause it's kind of whack, gotta move on. It's time to pack. Bull crap, you heard a lot of that. Baby daddy made it bad for the rest of the fellas. See where you development gets you. Then you're ahead of the women with a bit of heart. What's now in the light? What was in the dark? Running from the life, you ain't in the all. And then you went right, it began to fall. And you finally realized that you're moving too fast. 3 kids, 5 daddies, now you're doing the math. It's all about integrity, pursuing the bag. You deserve a victory now, for real.
I don't wanna play no type of game. I got ambitions, baby. I know that you've been through a lot of things. But I wanna change your mind. Sometimes I wonder if you know how beautiful you are. Cause I've been looking at you all night long. I've been looking at you, baby. I wanna put you back on track.
Yeah.
I wanna show you that I'm the real man for you, baby. I wanna give you all my racks. You got it.
Yeah, yeah.
Baby, you got it. You're an angel from above. Don't let him bring you down. Oh. You got it. I don't care about your past. Come follow my lead, baby. If you wanna live in peace.
Wanna take a trip back to motherland.
Yeah.
Shorty, you know that I got a big plan. Don't you worry about your ex, I'm your man.
I wanna show you my blueprint, shorty, what it do.
your light shine.
Welcome, welcome, welcome to Beyond the Radio.
Welcome to Beyond the Radio. And you better be smiling.
Beyond the fences in the building.
That's right. Welcome back to Beyond the Radio. I'm your co-host, Shay Samuels, Coach Shay Samuels, and I'm with your host, your main man, Coach David Benton. If you're just tuning in tonight, we are talking about one man planting a seed, another man watering, but God is going to give the increase. But before we go back into the show, let's go ahead and give a shout out to our sponsors. I'm going to quickly run through them, but you can make sure you find them on our Facebook page at Beyond the Radio, and make sure you hit that like button so you can get notifications when we give those shout outs. First, shout out to Paula G. Voice, Lady Wisdom After Midnight. If you heard the voiceover in the beginning, that was Paula G. PG is what we call her. If you are looking for a voiceover for your business, infomercials, commercials, if you are a music director and you're looking to insert a quality voiceover, we want you to look up Paula G. Voice. We've been saying it for a few years, and we know that y'all are calling. We've been saying it for a few years, but we want you guys to make sure that you bring in 2023 new, brand new in our G Will G Weezy voice. So you can reach her at www.paulag.voice.com or www.paulag.voice.com. Let her know that Beyond the Fence sent you. We also have our newest sponsor, Out of Town Auntie. That's O-U-T-T-A, Town Auntie. If you are an out of town auntie, you are always traveling, going somewhere, or maybe you have an out of town auntie and you want to bless her with something apparel-wise, make sure that you go to www.outoftownauntie.org and utilize the Beyond the Fence promo code. That's B-E-Y. O-N-D-A-F-E-N-C-E, and you will get 10% off of all apparel. You don't even have to tell them Beyond the Fence sent you. The promo code is going to say it. There are some amazing opportunities there for you to purchase sweatshirts, hoodies, purses, makeup bags, socks, luggage. You can go in style. If you have a girls trip, make it a girls trip where you are all dressed alike, maybe with different colors. Go Out of Town Auntie, and we thank you for being a sponsor. Mm-hmm. We want to give a great big shout out to DJ G Will. G Weezy is what I call him. If you're looking for a DJ, we want you to make sure you reach into G Will at www.beyondthefence.org. Email also at beyondoffense1@gmail.com, and we will make sure that G Will gets connected with you. Listen, I'm talking about virtual events, volleyball events, basketball events, workout events. There is no limit to what DJ G Will can and will do when it comes down to providing great music for you. So make sure you look him up. Last but not least, David, can I get a drum roll? Hey, shout out to our Beyond the Fence Expansion Company Let's Talk Business Consulting Strategy and Coaching Group, LLC. Listen, we are taking your business from zero to hero. I know people don't really use that anymore, but we have a 100% success rate, and I am so happy for the clients that we are assisting and getting you up and running. So if you are a new business, an existing business, and you're looking to do something different, listen, let's talk. Talk with Coach David and I. We will will get you in the right direction. Reach into us at aboutbuildingleaders@gmail.com. Connect with us on Facebook at Let's Talk Business Consulting Group and on Instagram at LTB. We have some amazing things coming up in January, and I want you guys to make sure you're connected. New workshops, new seminars, and we cannot forget to acknowledge the God is in Everything conference coming up January 21st, 2023. That information will be on the Beyond the Radio page as well. Coach David, back to you.
Actually, Coach, now you might well keep the baton because you got a story for us.
I do. So if you are tuned in to the first half of the show, I told you guys I'm going to share something with you because I want you to overcome the things that you have been going through. And it may not happen overnight, but I'm going to tell you that seed is so important. Since we're talking about one man planting a seed, another man nourishing, one man plants, another man waters, and God gives the increase. I need to tell you guys, a few weeks ago, I was at a leadership class with my church. Shout out to New Covenant. I was at a leadership class a few months ago now, and one of the things that the leader was talking about there, he was talking about leadership in your home. And so I was determined to come back with a new mindset that I was going to do something different in my home. For those of you who are listening, I want to tell you I have a 26-year-old, I have a 27-year-old, I have a 1-year-old and a 3-year-old, and we are all women living under one roof. Can you imagine? I remember when they were younger, Coach David, I would say they could stay as long as they want to, just as long as they enjoy life, right? I had no clue that we grow up and we have different personalities, and it's just going to be a catfight one day after another in this house. And so I remember saying before this leadership conference that things were getting worse every single day. I would wake up and I would share this with people. It's getting worse. And I was surprised when it was really getting worse, Coach David. I was saying, it's really getting worse. You know, I kept saying it like, it's getting worse. And I mean, I would call my mom. I'm talking to my mom about it. I know I shared it with you a few times and shared it with other people. But my shock in the fact that it was truly getting worse should not have shocked me. I remember someone saying to me, you got to be mindful of how powerful your tongue is. And I remember you talking with me, Coach David, about the power of manifestation. Right after that, someone was sharing with me the power of my tongue. And so, like you said, you have to be around some really good people to remind you in seasons, if you want to call them seasons of your life, or things that you might be going through in your life, these people should be able to pick up on something not being right, but also know how to get you right back on the right path. And so I remember speaking to somebody, and they said, you have to remember how powerful your tongue is. And so I was like, wow. And I had to laugh at myself, Coach David, and I'm talking to the listeners too. I had to laugh at myself because I kept saying, it's getting worse. And to my surprise, I was shocked that it was seriously getting worse. The arguments were getting worse every single day. We couldn't even look at each other for no reason. We'd just get up and be mad at one another. We went to go visit my brother in September, and when I say it was the worst of the worst, we had an explosion from my mom to myself to my daughters, my nieces, and my nephews. But keep in mind, it was after I made the decision to do something different in the house. So when we went to Florida, that was probably the worst experience that I had experienced ever with my whole family being there. And it was only my mom, myself, and my two daughters, and my nieces and my nephew who were impacted by this. Everybody else was having a good old time, but this was at its worst. I went back to the hotel, and I started to sit on the bed. I laid down, and I said, what is going on? And there's two things that came up. The first thing is, there was still something in my heart that was basically coming out.
Right.
Number two is I had an opportunity, Coach David, to sow the right seed at the time that I was in the situation with my mom and my daughters. I didn't. I said I wanted to be an example of what leadership looked like. And while I was lying in the bed that night at the hotel, all I could hear was, I gave you the opportunity to be that. So I want to encourage you tonight in my transparent moment that although you may have great seed in you, unless you know how to plant it, it's still not going to work. So I'm thankful for people like Coach David. I'm thankful for others who knew about the situation and started to talk about how powerful my tongue is. And guess what I started doing, Coach David? Every morning after I realized that, I started texting, every day it's getting better. I started texting to my family, really my daughters. I said, every day it's getting better. It's getting better every day. I would say good morning, and then the next thing I would say is, it's getting better every day. Now, I can't say that we've had an argument. We may not be where I would want us to be, but we have not had an argument. The house may not be as peaceful as I want it to be, but it's not where it was. And I had to laugh at the seed I was sowing and the shock that I had to know that that seed was actually growing. So I pray that that blessed somebody. I hope it blessed you. And I hope that you can see you in the situation, because at the end of the day, it's what you're sowing. Coach David, back to you.
Coach Shay, that was so powerful. I'm having one of the nights you be having when you talk about, I was just sitting back with my popcorn, just learning and listening. And just, you know, look, tonight my night.
I mean, it's just, it blew my mind. It blew my mind because then I started to utilize it. The power of a good seed is, you know, I started utilizing this very thing. And it's amazing how people will receive you. The right people receive the right seed, right? And so at the end of the day, what it boils down to is you have to be able to identify what the type of seed you are. Let me just sit that right there, because, Coach David, you even talked about it for your music. Beyond the Fence as a whole, we have inspirational recording artists. We have gospel recording artists. We have rappers. We have rappers that aren't even that aren't even in church. And we have a comedian who is not going to church every Sunday. We have a comedian. Shout out to Thomas Bigger. We have a comedian that's not even going. And so our impact when we come to you is that every person that touches the stage as a part of Beyond Offense is that our seed blesses you where you are. I got to say that again, that our seed individually blesses you where you are. As a whole, we have a seed, which is we want you to go beyond your fence. That's the seed that we want to plant.
Right.
Each person has their own story. I was a 16-year-old mother, had my second daughter at the age of 17. If you look at Thomas Baker, you'll see that he does, Tommy Two Toes, you'll see he doesn't have legs. He had a fence he had to go over. G Will has a fence that he had to go over. Miss Alma had a fence that she had to go over. You've heard Coach David's fence that he had to go beyond. And there's, and Tanya and DB Jr., fences that he had to go beyond. And so when we come up to the stage, we come up knowing that there's somebody that needs that seed. It won't be for everybody. A Shay Samuels won't be for everybody. A David Benton won't be for everybody. But our mission is to get you to go beyond your fence. So if you can look at that one seed that covers it all, I need to go beyond my fence, right? I need to go beyond my fence. And so that's what purpose will do for you. Coach David, I'm going to hand it back to you in a second. But that's what purpose will do for you. Your purpose is
Take
a seed.
Time.
Your purpose is a seed. So whenever you identify with purpose, then you know what seed you're going to sow into somebody. And it's so fortunate for those who are purpose-driven that your seed can change from a carnation to a rose, from a rose to a dandelion, a dandelion to a daisy. Because that's how purposeful you are. If you get stuck in, I'm just going to plant this one seed, then you're going to miss a variety of people. If you get stuck in, you know, think about it. For Coach Shay Samuels, I'm a recording artist, a TV personality. You hear me on radio. I'm a motivational speaker. I'm an author. Coach David, he's a transformational speaker. He's a radio personality. He's an artist. So there are different seeds that we have to be able to identify with so that we're planting the right seeds in you. what we talk about as far as our topics, these are also seeds that we plant in you, things that we've been through, conversations that we've had, things that we've seen break people. Listen, Coach David, how many times have we talked to people and what you would call, what people would call backslidden? There are people who are breaking down because of the wrong seed that has been planted. So with Coach David and I, we say, we're going to talk about that. Because
right.
somewhere along the line, somebody is sowing a bad seed. A bad seed can be seed of judgment. You may not
right.
even have to say a word, but the way you look at a person, that can you don't know what that person is dealing with internally. I don't know how many times I've heard a story of a young lady coming from out of a club, whether it was a strip club or a club, and she said God was just calling her to church that next morning. She went with all she had on, but the church looked at her like she was, you know, out of place. She smelled like smoke. She didn't have the right clothes on. And instead of the church embracing her, they sowed the wrong seed. So that young lady, whoever she was, didn't blame, you know, the church. It was God's people. So that person's
yeah.
never going to go to a church again. So the seed that was planted the first time around wasn't good ground. So guess what Coach David and I are going to do? We're going to hear that story, and we're going to come back to what God has given us, this platform, and start talking about it so people are aware that you're sowing this type of seed. Discord is another seed. Division is another seed. I said I was going to talk about all the good seed in the beginning and then talk about all the bad seed that's sown on the second half.
It's true.
But that's all seed. Because if you think about how quickly those seeds grow, why is it, Coach David, that the good seed takes a little bit longer than the bad seed to grow? You will see a weed grow faster than you will a flower.
Right. That's right. That's
but
cool, Coach. So you on one tonight.
You put me on one because you put me in. You said go, but I can remember.
No.
I remember we growing up. I'm gonna tell you how you fix that problem, listeners. A weed. There was a strand of weed growing up my brick, and the first time I had ever seen this, the little weed strand growing up in the middle of my bricks. And I wanted to pull them down myself, but I didn't know it had thorns on it. That's a whole nother topic, y'all, a weed with thorns. So I went to go pull the weed down, and the thorn actually pricked my finger, so I only got half of it down. And when I went back the next day to look at it, because I didn't get the rest of it, the part of the weeds that I tore down, it died.
Mm.
So the antidote to all of this is, you got to get around people who are going to sow good seed in you.
That's right.
You know, we've heard you reap what you sow. So if you're only sowing discord, if you're only sowing division, if you're only sowing gossip, if you're not sowing good fruit, I got to remind you that the Bible does say, and by their fruit you should know who they are. What are the people saying around you? Eventually you end up turning into that without even knowing. You become numb to it. You become numb to the negativity. You become numb to the division. You become numb to the discord. You start talking the way that you haven't, in a way you haven't talked before. And then one day, somebody who hadn't seen you in a long time, they're going to say, when did you start talking like that? It's all about the seed.
Yes.
I can sing songs in my home that are very spirit-driven. My children who aren't spirit, they don't go to church, very, very spirit driven, they just don't go to church. But I'm saying they wouldn't sing these songs, let's just say that. So if I'm just going around the house singing, all hail King Jesus, and then I hear my daughter singing it about an hour later, it's what she heard, the seed was planted. My one-year-old and my three-year-old granddaughter, I'm telling you, if I say something, they're at that point where they're going to repeat everything that I say. So what seed am I planting in them now that's going to allow them to be able to regurgitate that back to other people? Now, everybody not like that, Coach David. No matter how much good seed you put in that person, they just are who they are. They'll get it. That's the part where God is going to give the increase. All you have to do and all you're charged with is either planting the seed or being the waterer. Yes.
That's right.
Too many of us are trying to be God. Too many of us are trying to be the nourisher and give the increase. Two commands. One is the one plants the sower, and then the other is going to water. So you're going to meet somebody. And when you decide you want to plant the right seed, let's just say it's the young lady who came from the club and went to church. If you say, honey, we welcome you here, that is a great seed. She may not come back for a year, but she's going to remember what you said. And then she won't be afraid to go into another church. And that church, again, may plant another seed. It may take three churches before she starts to even accept the watering. But the whole time, God is nourishing. God is providing the increase. If we believe that, we don't really have to do anything more than be the sower or the waterer.
Right. That's right.
That's it. Back to you, Coach David. I feel like you got something deep down in you.
It was just so powerful. All I was doing is just absorbing the information. You know, I'm on the other end listening, just like our listeners. So just to hear it, you know, just getting on the receiving end, it was just powerful. It was necessary. It's really not. There's nothing even to come behind. The only thing I can say is job well done. You know, like this is necessary because we know, like. You know, I do have people. I do want people to understand when it comes to Beyond the Fence. You know, I am having, you know, guys who do music. They do say use profanity. The way they express it is not the way I express it. I don't use no profanity in my music. All my music is very clean. It's radio. Everything radio edits because that's who I am as an artist. But another artist may. You know, express himself another way, but no way, form, or fashion. It got to be something where it's helping people, not hurting them. You know, I'm not about destroying our community. You know, you don't got to be all political, right. But we ain't talking about killing nobody. You know what I'm saying? We're not doing that. We're not saying go sell drugs and pop ecstasy pills and jump off of the bridge. Nobody's saying that. We talk about grown adults, but they might talk about something. And I'm like, understand this is not a target for you. Like, we're not even giving you this music. You see it, but we're not giving it to you, saying listen to it. We got a whole nother crowd saying, hey, check this out. And that's just the reality, man. Like, people might not agree with you, and that's fine. That don't make them bad people. That just make them different from your thoughts. Your thoughts and their thoughts are different. And I'm just saying, like, we got to coexist in this world. Fish in the sea do it all the time. And we supposed to be more superior. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
The lion hunting for food, they trying to survive. They ain't killing because they mad at them. they just trying to survive.
Right.
So the lion, man, he got to go hunt. It ain't like he like, look, man, you know, I'm about to go murder me somebody because I'm the lion. Nobody, I ain't going to be playing no games. I'm real. The lion ain't being a bully. He just feeding his family and himself. Well, herself, because the female is the one go do the killing. But they're surviving and feeding their family with it. But all I'm saying is lions, tigers, bears, they all can live in this jungle. And they're not tripping out because they're different. You know, there's a territory, and it's like up to that person not to cross this territory, and they smell them.
Yeah.
It's called respect. It's simply called respect. Let's respect each other's differences. And how can you use them to your advantage to where we all can be in a win-win column? Let's just come together. You have that power within you because you are great. Y'all are kings and queens, men and women of God, blessed and highly favored for real. All we got to do is just walk in it. Just walk in it.
Yeah.
What more can God ask from them? God ain't asking a lot from us. just obedience. Because obedience is better than sacrifice. And with that being said, y'all come next week right here on Beyond the Radio. We love y'all. We appreciate y'all. Y'all follow us on Beyond the Fence Facebook page. That's BEYONDAFENCE. Y'all go to our website. It's beyondthefence.org. We see y'all next week. We love y'all.
We do want to give a great big shout out to the Jewel. Shout out to the Jewel and shout out to Vonda Thorpe of Douglasville, Georgia as well for an amazing event this week. We love you guys.
Yes. Miss Solomon. Miss Solomon and Jewel, y'all did so great. Like y'all, oh my God, they were so awesome. And we love y'all.
We love
Beyond
you.
Beyond the Fence in the building.
But with that being said,
where the music.
Where the music at?
Where the music.
Simple man.